The Poco M3 is a budget smartphone and is priced under 15,000. It has a 6.53-inch Full HD Plus display with a dewdrop notch at the top. It has a side-mounted fingerprint scanner, stereo speakers, and an IR emitter to control appliances. This smartphone has a triple camera setup at the back. It is quite well-designed and looks far more premium than it is actually priced. The rear panel has a textured finish which helps keep fingerprints away. The phone is powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 662 processor and gets 6 GB of RAM. There are two storage variants available, 64 GB and 128 GB. Storage is expandable via dedicated microSD card slot, and it accepts cards up to 512 GB. It packs in a 6000 mAh battery which is good for the price. It has support for 18W charging and gets a 22.5-watt charger in the box. The Poco M3 is capable of handling day-to-day tasks, and the battery managed to last for a day and a half. The big battery does help with battery life, but it takes over 2 hours to charge it completely. With 6 GB of RAM on board, it is capable of multitasking very easily. You can play most games, but with heavier games, it tends to get warm to the touch. You get a 48-megapixel primary camera, a 2-megapixel macro camera, and a 2-megapixel depth sensor on the Poco M3. The Moto G9 is a budget offering from Motorola with some powerful hardware. It sports a 6.5-inch LCD display with HD Plus resolution and a tall 29 aspect ratio. The phone has flat sides which make it comfortable to hold, and its rear-mounted fingerprint scanner is easy to reach. Motorola has packed in a 5000 mAh battery which has caused it to tip the scales at 200 grams. It runs clean stock Android 10 with Motorola's MIUX on top. There are very few useful customizations on top. You also get a dedicated Google Assistant button on the G9. The smartphone is powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 662 SoC and is available in one variant only with 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of storage. The Moto G9 gets a triple camera setup consisting of a 48-megapixel primary camera with an f1.7 aperture, a 2-megapixel macro camera, and a 2-megapixel depth sensor. It clicks decent photos in favorable light with good details. It is missing a wide-angle camera that most of its competition sport. The macro camera is good, but it is of a lower resolution. Low-light camera performance was average, but the night mode is very effective. The Realme 7 brings in three main upgrades over the Realme 6: a new SoC, a bigger battery, and a new primary camera sensor. It features a mirror split design, which creates some interesting patterns when light hits it. The Realme 7 is actually thicker, 9.4 millimeters, and heavier, 196.5 grams, than the 6, due to its larger battery, and this is very noticeable in daily usage. The Realme 7 is the first phone to debut with the MediaTek Helio G95 SoC. This is an updated version of the Helio G90T, which was seen in the Realme 6, but it's not a major upgrade. Performance is pretty satisfactory. The Realme 7 uses Realme UI, based on Android 10, which worked smoothly. Face recognition and the side-mounted fingerprint sensor are also quick. The Realme 7 is good with games too. Battle Prime looked great at the highest graphics settings and gameplay was smooth. The Realme 7 gets a chunky 5000 mAh battery, and you can charge the battery fairly quickly too, thanks to the 30W DAR charge fast charging. The Poco M2 Pro has an attractive design and is built well, but it also looks very similar to the Redmi Note 9 Pro. It features a P2i water repellent coating, which is said to make it splash proof. Poco has used a 6.67 inch Full HD Plus LCD display, with a cutout for the selfie camera. You also get Gorilla Glass 5 on the front, back, and the rear camera module. One feature that's missing is a high refresh rate. The Poco M2 Pro runs on MIUI 11, which is based on Android 10, and my unit had the June security patch. Apart from having the Poco launcher as a default, the features and functionality are very similar to what you get on Redmi devices. MIUI and app performance were superb, thanks to the Qualcomm Snapdragon 720G SoC. Navigating through MIUI's interface felt snappy, multitasking worked well, and apps in general were quick to load. Gaming performance was very good too. The 5000 mAh capacity easily lasted for an entire day, even with lots of gaming and camera usage. The Realme 6i is a budget smartphone from Realme and is a toned-down version of the Realme 6. This smartphone sports some interesting hardware such as the 90Hz display which isn't available from the competition. The Realme 6 sports a 6.5-inch display and has a hole punch designed to accommodate the selfie camera. Powering the Realme 6i is a MediaTek Helio G90T SoC, which is paired with either 4GB or 6GB of RAM. The storage between both variants remains the same at 64GB. The Realme 6i has a quad camera setup at the back with a 48-megapixel primary camera, an 8-megapixel ultra-wide-angle camera, a 2-megapixel macro camera and a 2-megapixel depth sensor. The phone runs Realme UI on top of Android 10. There is some amount of bloatware that comes pre-installed on the device, and we did encounter some spammy notifications. The camera performance from the Realme 6i was good in daylight using the primary camera. Its wide-angle camera offered decent details. Low-light camera performance wasn't as good, as we saw a noticeable dip in performance.